We are going to learn how to create an APA-style frequency table using JASP, Microsoft Word, and Excel. Typically, you will use Microsoft Word for writing your research paper. And although Word has some tools for building tables, the secret to creating a proper table in Microsoft Word is to use Microsoft Excel. All of the techniques that I will show you will also work if you are using some other writing and spreadsheet software, such as OpenOffice or LibreOffice. I am using a fictitious dataset, MyClass.sav. This is actually an SPSS dataset, but we can open it easily in JASP. I will be focusing on the variable quiz 4. These are scores on a statistics quiz for 112 students. The possible range of scores is 0 to 10 points. Sometimes it's good to start with the ending. For instance, I want to begin by showing you the final product of this lesson so that you will know what we are trying to achieve. We will create a finished APA-style frequency table just like this. Our frequency table will include the range of scores in descending order. Simple frequency. Relative frequency. Cumulative frequency. And percentile. As well as the sample size, which will go in the table title. To do this, we are going to get a frequency table from JASP that looks like this. Although it is similar, it does not contain all of the columns that we need. We will have to compute the last three columns in Excel. This JASP table is not so different from the same frequency table that we would get from SPSS, which would look like this. Actually, all of the data are the same, except JASP includes some information on missing data. Here is our workflow. We will calculate basic frequencies in JASP. We will copy the results into Excel, where we will then create and format our frequency table. Then, we will bring the finished table into a research paper in Word. This is a realistic workflow that you might follow for a real-world write-up. Once you have JASP open, we will open our data by going to our main menu icon. Open, Computer, Desktop. Locate the MyClass.sav dataset and click Open. As I mentioned, this is an SPSS dataset. JASP can open an SPSS file directly, as well as CSV datasets, but not an Excel file. Those have to be converted to a CSV first. As you can see, JASP has read the file and is showing you the data. We are interested in the variable quiz 4, scores for a statistics quiz on a scale of 0 to 10. JASP has correctly interpreted the level of measurement for this variable as scale. However, we will need to change this, as I will show you in a moment. Frequency is a descriptive statistic, so we will be using this descriptives menu. Select the option for descriptive statistics. In the results pane, we already see the table where the descriptive statistics are going to appear. Move quiz 4 into the variables box. JASP uses progressive disclosure. In the results pane, as soon as we enter the variable, we already get a table with some descriptive statistics. Of course, we are interested in a frequency table. And here is an option to ask for that table. Because of progressive disclosure, you would expect to see the frequency table appear. But it does not. The problem, as you may have already figured out, is that frequency tables are for nominal and ordinal variables. But quiz 4 has been coded as a scale variable. So what can we do? First, let's take a look at our variable in the dataset. Click on the disclosure triangle in the left column to show data. quiz 4 is properly coded as a scale variable. JASP is saying that it will only do a frequency table on nominal and ordinal data. Well, that makes sense. Typically, we do not want frequency tables for continuous variables without categories. They're too big, they're cumbersome, and quite honestly, they're useless. On the other hand, in this case, we actually do want a frequency table for what we have listed as a scale variable. Well, this is a pickle. How can we get a frequency table for our scale data? We lie. JASP is saying, I won't give you a table unless your data are nominal, which is really for our own benefit. So we say, all right then, these data are nominal, even though we know that they're actually scale. And then JASP says, oh, well, in that case, here you go. And it gives us the table. Remember, you were not created for the software. The software was created for you. You tell the software what to do, not the other way around. Hover your cursor over the scale icon and click here to change column type. Change it to nominal. This change now allows us to do something else very important that we could not do with our data set to scale. Recall that frequency tables display the scores in descending order. We need to ask for that too. Hover your cursor over the word quiz 4 and click here to change labels. This is something else that we can only do with nominal and ordinal variables. We see the current values and labels. They are in ascending order with the smallest values on top. Click the double arrows to reverse order all of the labels. This reorders the sequence as 10, 9, 8, etc., just as we wanted. And now, click on the disclosure triangle in the right column to hide data and to reveal the frequency table in the results pane. There it is. We have 4 columns, including frequency. The sample size is down here, 112. Because we have no missing cases, the percent and the valid percent columns are exactly the same. Looks like everything that we need for our finished table, right? Not so fast. Actually, there is only one usable column of data here. Look at the column headings. We want simple frequency for our table, so we need this first column, labeled frequency. We also want relative frequency, cumulative frequency, and percentile. But these columns are for percent, valid percent, and cumulative percent, and this is cumulative percent, not cumulative frequency. The only data that are useful to us are the descending list of scores and the simple frequency. Now, there are a few other things to notice with this table. Look at this list of quiz scores. Yes, they are in descending order, but what else do you see? Several missing categories. We are missing a 4 and a 1. So we have some work to do. One of the benefits of JASP is that JASP gives us nicely formatted tables and figures. Sometimes you can copy these tables directly into your publication or poster. In this case, however, we are going to copy this table into Excel and then create a new table using these data. Hover your cursor over the titles for this table and you will see disclosure triangles appear. Click on the triangle next to the table title and you can copy LaTeX, or add note. We want to copy this table to our clipboard. Now open a new Excel workbook. Paste the table into cell A1. Now we are ready to do some editing and to create our frequency table. First, I can add column headings where I will be creating my new table. Across the top row, type score, F for simple frequency. We need relative frequency, cumulative frequency, and percentile. Formatting note, use a lowercase f to stand for frequency. You should set it in italics. Or, if you want this cool F, type Option F on Mac or Alt F on PC. Next, we should copy our scores into the score category. And we can copy our frequency data and place it in the frequency column. Next, let's deal with these missing categories. Highlight the entirety of row 3, and then right-click, or control-click, on the table. Choose Insert from the drop-down menu. This is our row for the score of 4. We also need a row for the score of 1. Now that we have the rows for our missing categories, we need to add their frequencies. The fact that they were missing in JASP means that they both had a frequency of 0. So now we are ready to calculate relative frequency, cumulative frequency, and percentiles. We will use Excel formulas to do the math for us. For instance, the relative frequency is the proportion of times that a score occurs. Relative frequency is the simple frequency divided by the sample size. In cell C17, type the formula equal sign B17 divided by 112. After you type an equal sign and are creating the formula, you can simply click on cells to reference them. Drag the formula down to copy it. The cumulative frequency is the frequency of all the scores at and below a particular score. The cumulative frequency of a score is the frequency of that score plus the cumulative frequencies of all the scores below it. To create this column, we need to start at the bottom. Type 2 for the first cumulative frequency, same as the simple frequency. Above that, in cell D26, we want the previous cumulative frequency added to the next simple frequency. Now drag that formula up the column. The top cumulative frequency will be the same as the sample size. Finally, percentile is the percent of all of the scores in the data that are at or below a certain score. Percentile is the cumulative frequency divided by sample size, times 100. Start with the numbers in the CF column. Transform each cumulative frequency value to a percentile by dividing the cumulative frequency by n, 112, then multiplying by 100. Double-click to copy that formula down and to complete the column. Now we have all of the data in place. We can also do our APA formatting right here in Excel. First, let's clear out everything that we do not need. Drag to select the entire table. And using the Borders tool, select No Border. If you had copied in a table from JASP that had shading, you would clear any shading by selecting the Fill Color tool and choose No Fill. The font for this table will be Times New Roman 12 point. Good. Now we need to add rules, horizontal black lines, above and below the table. Excel calls them borders. Highlight the top row of data along our 5 columns. Using the Borders tool, we will add a top rule and a bottom rule on the top row. We will also add a bottom rule below the last row of data. Rather than using the column spacing that Excel gives us, let's select the entire range of columns and adjust their width slightly. They can be a little narrower. I like to keep all of the columns the same width when I can. Next, we should center the titles in the header row. And we should center the scores in the first column. Right justify all scores in other cells. This will help the decimal points line up correctly. And speaking of decimals, we can use the formatting tools to adjust the display of decimals. Let's select these two columns, which I am selecting by holding down the Command key on Mac, and use the Decrease Decimal tool to make them all two decimals. You can also change these decimals one column at a time. Of course, cumulative frequency does not need decimals, so we can select only that column and set the decimals to zero. Okay, so we are done formatting the APA style table. It's time to get this table into Word and finish it. Select the entire table. Copy. And open a Word document. This is an example document that I made up as if it were a class paper. Notice that I referenced the table in the preceding paragraph, as you should. Paste the formatted table here. Now we need to title the table. Each table must have a number and a title. Numbers run sequentially. Your first table is titled Table 1. Your second would be titled Table 2, and so on. On the next line, add the title, Frequencies of Scores for Quiz 4. This is a good place to add the sample size as well, in parentheses. Table titles are always in title case and are italicized. And there is our properly formatted APA-style frequency table, created using JASP.